This is a carburetor from a 46 to 48 flathead Ford V8. I've got it disassembled and cleaned. Now it's time to assemble it. Got a rebuild kit, replace all the gaskets, replace your accelerator pump, replace the needle for the float, replace the needle itself. Anyway, all the parts are here. Time to put it together. I've already tested this float to make sure it doesn't leak. Easy way to do that is to take a glass full of hot water, dip it inside the glass. If you see any bubbles come out of the float, then you know it's leaking. That's why you want to use hot water so that you'll heat up the air inside the float. And then it'll be that much easier for it to expand and leave, and then you'll see it leaking out. Anyway, we gotta set the float height. Whoa, this is way off. Needs to be way up here. For this carburetor, float height needs to be at 1 inch and 11/32. So you can cut this paper gauge, and you can hold it here. You hold it up against the machine surface here. And it should be right like this. It's not, so we need to bend the tang. When you do this, you want to be real careful. So that you do not destroy this float. The float portion is very fragile. You also do not want to do it against the needle. You can destroy the needle if you put too much pressure on the needle. I'm going to come in here like this. Bend this guy like that. See what we get. Okay, we're getting closer. Hold our gauge up here and... yeah, that's very good. Try it over here. You want to measure it on both sides of the float. Yeah. Yep, that'll do it. The other thing you want to measure is the drop. So the float will drop like this. Drop's supposed to be 1.5. 1/7/16. Yep. Looks real good. All right. This is the power valve. It's also called an enrichner on the old carbs, but on the Holley carbs today, this is typically described as a power valve. This guy goes in right here. Don't forget your gasket. This is the accelerator pump. It's got a spring at the bottom. You got your plunger, your piston, spring at the top. Base gasket, you always want to check the holes with the passageways in the base. For this particular gasket, doesn't matter, we can have it switched. Some carburetors you cannot, it has to be a certain way. You don't get it on right, you'll block one of the passages. This particular carburetor, doesn't matter. These Venturis have a pokey oak, it's a little tab. And what'll happen here is you can only put it in one way. See, it can't go in that way, it has to go here. It also can't go in, switch around 180 degrees there. So this one has to go in like this. And this one has to go in like this. Your accelerator pump shooter goes right here in the middle. Jets go in here. plugs go in here. These are the idle mixture screws. They go in here. Idle mixture screws need to be set to 1 1/2 turns out. So what you do is you screw these in and you very lightly seat them. So there it's seated at the bottom. And you come out 1/2, 1 1/2 turns. Lightly seated at the bottom. 1/2, 1 1/2 turns. And that's just going to get you approximately where you need to be. Once you get your engine running, you may have to adjust these slightly. Here's the top. Yep, need to watch this lever arm over here. Something wasn't right there. Get these out of here. Pull your lever arm back. Now the top can sit as it should. Yep, there we go. Now all we need is the choke lever. So this carburetor has a manual choke. You can see it's spring-loaded, so it closes. This is a detent with a spring. Detent goes in the hole. Lever goes on here. You want to get this opened up so you can get your lever in place. And your washer and your screw. Yep, there we go. You'll put your manual choke cable in here, and then your choke's closed, choke's open. It's working good. And it also works this lever arm to give you a fast idle. You can see here it pushes that out, and then your fast idle adjustment's here. So that's it, ready to go. Ready to put on the engine, get this thing running.